FATCA is about identifying U.S. persons who are avoiding U.S. tax through the use of offshore accounts or offshore vehicles. To do this, the government has asked financial services firms to provide an important role in documenting their account holders and where those account holders do not meet the requirements for FATCA to withhold upon them. FATCA, again, is a very complex set of tax requirements, although this time it's likely to impact the majority of the financial business units within a complex financial institution. So you have to think about the coordination that's going to be involved to truly comply with FATCA. You're going to have to coordinate across geographies, across business units, and across entities. FATCA is also complex when it comes to actually within a business unit. Because of the nature of having to reach out to your customers, how the operations impacts, the technology impacts, it cuts across the platforms within your individual business unit. From an operations standpoint, different areas will be taking the lead at different aspects of the program.
When I hear all of my colleagues here talk about the different requirements and business impacts, what immediately that correlates to me is some fairly obvious IT impacts, the new data points that you're going to have to store that you may not today. Dave and Irene both mentioned, do you link some systems from an account master perspective that may be in disparate places? How are you going to capture those substantial U.S. owners that are sitting behind some of these entities? What is going to be your impact to your new account opening wizards, your document imaging system, your document tracking systems? Do you have those? Do you need to build them? Things like that. Those are some of the more obvious things we need to be concerned with. I would urge that we resist the temptation to just limit the scope of what's my one little field that I need to add. We've got to look at it in the context of not only what am I going to add, but how am I going to use it, and why do I need it? How is this going to eventually play into my tax withholding systems? How is this eventually going to play into my reporting systems? Do I need to integrate this with other applications down the stream, aligned with my business process and my either conservative or aggressive nature, however I want to handle this type of process? We need to look at that, otherwise we run the risk of building multiple times, and that in and of itself adds inherent risk that we can't afford at this point.
Something else to consider is that with these complex forms, the W-8-BEN form, the W-8-IMY form, they are going to be more complex, but the first thing you have to remember when you look at a document is that you've got to pass through that FATCA hoop first. So you're going to make sure, okay, I don't have to apply FATCA withholding. And then once you figure that out, did they fill out that portion of the form right, then you got to look at the Chapter 3 or the NRA side of the equation and see whether or not they may be eligible for treaty benefits and all of that. So it's going to be, every time you look at a form, it's going to be double the work at least.